I'm going to build an example model that uses a process flow to control an operator. This is an approach you can use when the behavior of the operator needs to be defined in a very specific way that does not conform to the basic task sequences defined by standard 3D objects like queues and processors. Let me begin by describing the scenario for the model. Okay, there are two types of boxes that arrive at two separate queues, a red box queue and a green box queue. The boxes need to be carried by an operator, one at a time, over to a takeaway conveyor in a very specific order. The operators have been instructed to first take two red boxes, then two green boxes, then back to two red boxes, and so on. This situation would be a real challenge using just the options available in the standard 3D objects, so this is a good candidate for using process flow. In my process flow, I will be taking advantage of the event triggered source, a list, and a run subflow activity. Okay, I'm ready to start building the model now. I'll begin with the 3D layout. First, a couple of sources, one for each box type, and a respective queue for each of the sources. And then a queue acting as the feeder point into the conveyor. I'll use a straight conveyor section, starting it here and ending it here. And then I'll finish off with a sink. Now, as far as connections go, I'm just going to make connections between the source and their queues. And then from the queue to the conveyor and conveyor to the sink. I'm not going to connect the queues together because I'll be using process flow to define that. Okay, I do not need to do much editing on the 3D objects other than I want to add a trigger to each of the sources that will add a label to the flow items as they're created. So I'll use the onCreation trigger and a pick option under data called set, label, and color. The label name will be type and the value will be 1 for source 1. And on source 2, I'll be doing the same thing but set the type label value to a 2. And the color, by default, will be red for type 1 and green for type 2. Now, I want to add a couple operators to the model. I'll make one a male, and I'll make the other one a female, so we can easily tell them apart. And then I want to shift select to get them both selected, and right-click on one of them. Go to Objects Group and Add to New Group. I want to place both of these operators in a group I'll call Ops, O-P-S. Now, I'm ready to create a process flow and define the behavior of the operators. I'll add a general process flow. It'll begin with a couple event-triggered sources. One here, then I'll just double-click and do this the quick way. Select event-triggered source here for the second one. I'll use the eyedropper to select which object in the model I want to listen to and choose the event of on entry. I'll do that for both queues. So whenever a box or item enters these queues, an event will fire. I'll call this one the type 1 items. And for the entering item, I want to create a label on my token called item and assign it to the entering item. And I'll do this for both queues. So the label is called item with a capital I note and use the assign operator. That'll get the tokens labeled up so I have a clear reference to the item they're associated with. Now next I want to use a push to list. And let me create a local list. I'll name this the list of items to transport. Now I want to add a field to this list. I want this new field to contain the flow item's type label value, a 1 or a 2, that were assigned to the flow items when they were created at the sources in the 3D model. I want to rename the push to list items to transport, because that's what we're doing, creating a list of flow items that need transported. Now our push value is going to be the token label item. It'll be a reference to the flow item. Resize things so I can make them easier to read. Now that's the end of this little flow except for a sink. Let me add that. And now I want to put this all in a container for organization purposes. So I'll go to the display, choose this, choose the process icon at square, rename it item flow, create list of items. That's the purpose of this little grouping of activities. I'll resize the container. And I need to connect things up still. So let me drag a connection from this source to the push to list and this source. Okay, on to the next container. I'll start off with a container this time. I'll name it operator flow. It'll be a list of instructions for the operators to follow. It's going to begin with a source activity, just a regular scheduled source. It's going to be create one token per operator, so that's what I'll put in the name, and change the quantity to 2, one token for each of our 2 operators. Okay, from here I want to acquire an operator. So I'll use the acquire resource, and then I'll create a resource. I'll associate this resource with the operators group. Let me rename it operator. And for the reference, use the sampler button. Click on either one of the operators and choose group, ops. Okay, after acquiring an operator, I want to pull from the list. I need to first pull the flow items that I want to pick up off the list. So I'll use the sampler to reference the same list I created up above. This will be the type 1 items. I want to request 2. Remember, I want to first pick up 2 red boxes, and then 2 green, about one at a time. Okay, the label name, I'll come up with a new label name. I'll call it type 1 items. One label will contain a reference to both items it pulls. The query now will say where type equals a 1. Let me change the default to equal 1. Just use one equal sign here. So I chose to use a query as a way of distinguishing which things to pull off the list. After that, rather than have all my instructions right here, I'm going to call a subflow. And the subflow will be the instructions for the operator to travel, etc. I'll sample down here for the activity I want to be the start of the subflow. Let me put this in a container as well. I'll call this the subflow process, or just the subflow. And it'll contain the transport item tasks or activities. Okay, back on the run subflow. Let me identify it as the subflow that will transport type 1 items. The quantity of tokens I want it to create is 2, but rather than hard code it with 2, I'm going to use the type 1 items label, which gets created in the pull from list. And then use the dot length keyword. It will tell me how many items are in the array of that label. Uncheck the label access on parents only. And I want to add a label to these tokens. I'll call it item, because I want it to have a reference to the flow item out in the model. Now to do that, I'm going to use the type 1 items label. And I'm going to use creation rank as the index number. That's a local variable I have access to in that value field. It'll be a 1 for the first item created by the subflow and a 2 for the second item. Then I can just copy paste. So I use Control C, Control V, and update this set of 2 activities to be for the type 2 items that get pulled from the list first, and then run subflow is fired for picking up both of the green or type 2 items. Just need to go through and make sure I change everything properly where it said a 1, change it to a 2 now. Otherwise, it's the same. Okay, now I'm ready to create my subflow. These are task sequence activities. First will be a travel task, travel to an object. I'm going to travel to the item itself. So I need to give a reference to either a task sequence or the task executor. I'm going to use a reference to the task executor. And to do that, I can look at the resource label on the token. And here, I'm going to use the token.item label for the destination. So token.resource is a label that got assigned up on the acquire activity. That's the default name for the label. I didn't type that in, but I'm referencing it here as a way to reference the resource that got acquired, or the operator, in other words. So then after I travel there, I need to load the item. And then travel to the drop-off queue, which is Q3. I'll rename this. Once again, the executor I can reference with token.resource. And the destination I'll sample Q3 out in the model. Okay, then I need to unload, so I'll use the unload activity. Need to unload the item in that station. And this is all just a repeat, token.resource, and the item is token.item. Don't use the default in there, that's a lowercase I. We want to use our uppercase I that we defined. And then I need to sample Q3 again as the station. Now, I finish this off with a finish activity that marks the end of a subflow and passes control back to the run subflow activity up above. Finish off this connection here. And I need to finish the loop. So those two tokens in that operator flow, they just keep looping around and around, telling the operator to do it again. Pick up two reds and then pick up two greens. Let's run it and see if we've got any errors or any problems. Okay, oop, got an error. It says there's an error in the subflow for loading an item, so I'll fix that. And yep, I forgot to fill this one out, didn't I? Need token.resource and token.item. That was an oversight. Let me close the system console. And now let's restart the model and see if we have any errors or any other problems. No, no errors, but we're carrying two boxes at a time. Well, that's easily fixed. Stop the model, reset, and then I'll go to the run subflow activities and check this box here to run the tokens one at a time. It created two tokens, sent them over, and they both got started at the same time. This will do them individually. Let's see if it's working. All right, one at a time. Make sure he starts picking up greens next. And if a red box enters, there goes the other operator, the female operator. Well, it looks like everything is working fine. This concludes the end of this video presentation. Thank you for watching.